When ownership management is enabled, the Manage Ownership page is available when you select Consolidation from the application cluster. Enabling the Ownership Management feature allows you to assign ownership percentages and consolidation methods to entity hierarchies. You can enable the Ownership Management feature for both new and existing applications. When you create a new application, you can enable Ownership Management on the Features tab. The Ownership Management option for a new application is available only if you select the Intercompany Data with Tracking option. This option enables you to track your intercompany elimination data separately by data source. If you do not select Ownership Management during application creation, you can enable Ownership Management after the application is created, provided the Intercompany Data with Tracking option is enabled. When you enable Ownership Management, you have the option to include Equity Pickup to enable the Equity Pickup method of recording the value of investments in subsidiaries, Partner Elimination to enable rules to write data to a partner member, or Enhanced Organization by Period to allow the addition of new shared entities without requiring data already locked to be unlocked and reconsolidated. To enable the Ownership Management option for an existing application, intercompany data with tracking must already be enabled. However, if you did not enable intercompany data with tracking during application creation, you must recreate the application and enable intercompany data with tracking in order to enable the Ownership Management feature. Now, let's explore the changes to an application when you enable intercompany data with tracking and ownership management is enabled, but without the equity pickup, partner elimination, and enhanced organization by period options. When you enable intercompany data with tracking, the system creates an intercompany dimension, as well as the members FCCS_elimination in the consolidation dimension, and FCCS_intercompany eliminations in the data source dimension. In the account dimension, seeded system accounts are added to support consolidation rules. The updated total assets hierarchy is shown here with the new accounts highlighted in red. In addition, the data storage property of the existing FCCS_percent console member is changed from store to dynamic calc. This account will be dynamically calculated based on the entered ownership information. New accounts are also added to the FCCS_total equity hierarchy and the FCCS_drivers hierarchy. Changes are also made to the consolidation dimension. The FCCS_proportion member is no longer the parent member for FCCS_entity total. Instead, it is now a sibling of FCCS_entity total, and its data storage property is changed from dynamic calc to store. A new hierarchy named FCCS_entity total adjustment is added with child members, FCCS_entity elimination adjustment, and FCCS_entity proportion adjustment. Note that the data storage change from dynamic calc to store for the FCCS_proportion member requires that you reconsolidate all existing data within the application to calculate the proportion member and store it in the consolidation dimension. After reconsolidation, the calculation status is changed to impacted for all entities. In the movement dimension, members for acquisitions and disposals are added to the investing hierarchy. The data source dimension is also updated. FCCS_acquisitions/disposals is added to capture system-generated ownership adjustments and eliminations. A hierarchy named FCCS_source entities is created for use in ownership management. One final note. When you enable ownership management, the system adds new seeded account and movement members with aliases to support the seeded consolidation rules. For example, the FCCS_dividends receivable member is added to the account dimension with the alias dividends receivable. This may result in a duplicate alias error with the existing members in the application. Therefore, before you enable ownership management in an existing application, you should review the list in the FCC Administration Guide of new seated members that will be created, and delete or modify defined members that serve the same purpose to avoid a conflict with the new seated members. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.